I am Dr. Venkataram, Mysore, dermatologist, dermatopathologist, hair transplant surgeon and director at Venkat Center for Skin, ENT and Plastic Surgery, Vijayanagar, Banashankari, Cunningham Road, Bangalore. Is fat transfer useful for treating hair loss? Can fat stem cells stimulate hair growth? This is a question which is much being seen and debated and circulated on the internet. This is a relatively new area, and so it is important to understand what it can and what it cannot do. The hair follicle is very closely interacting with the fat. Beneath the root of the hair, or what we call the bulb, there is a small amount of fat. So this close interaction is well established. Fat tissue has one of the highest concentration of stem cells, that is also well established. Stem cells can convert themselves into any other type of cell, that is why they are called stem cell, that is also well established. So this treatment has some sound logic in theory. Recently there are a number of techniques which have become available wherein we can only take out these fractions which are rich in stem cell, what is called stem cell vascular fraction, or another process through mechanical means, what is called nanofat. So these hardly contain any fat, they are rich in stem cells. They are then injected into the hair loss area, and it's an outpatient procedure. You take about 20 to 30 ml of fat from the abdomen through a small hole made in the skin, 4 millimeter hole, and then you centrifuge it, you mix it, you manipulate it for about 20 minutes, and then you inject it in multiple areas. This is the procedure. And what are the results? Now we have to be careful here in assessing it. It is a relatively new area. There are about 14 to 16 research papers on this topic, and results are modest. I want to confirm here that this is not an established routine treatment for androgenetic alopecia or baldness. This is a recently introduced treatment with early results. The level of evidence, we have 4 level of evidence. Level A is the highest, level D is the lowest. Level of evidence for this is around level C. So it's an exciting area, but more evidence is needed before we can recommend it to everybody. And what is important is that proper information is given to the patient without any hype. So I request patients to note it, that it is a new area, exciting area, but still not with full set of evidence to be used as a first choice treatment. Thank you very much.